Hi. Parajumbles, a topic massively in request. A lot of people keep asking about parajumbles, okay? Now, the unfortunate thing with parajumbles is that there isn't really any theory behind it. You know, like there aren't certain concepts or certain fundamentals that I can try telling you and then based on that you can work on. If you actually ask me, this is just another way of checking your RC skills and little bit of logic skills. RC skills because, you know, do you know what connects with what? What kind of things should come earlier? What kind of things should come later? And so on. And logic skills, I think, again, similar stuff that, you know, do you go from general to specific, and is a conclusion being made, and if the conclusion is being made, then more often than not, the data or the premises for that conclusion would be before the conclusion, and so on and so forth, okay? So, combination of logical and RC skills, of course, analytical skills also to work this all together and so on. So that is what parajumbles are. So I don't think I can spend too much time on theory, but a little bit I think should be useful for you. So one of the first things that I ask people while doing parajumbles is the exact opposite of what a lot of students do, which is that they start looking for a starting sentence, meaning the beginning sentence of a parajumble. I'm sorry, I didn't really explain. I'm assuming you know what this is since you're watching these videos, but just in case, so let me just explain what parajumbles are. Parajumbles, as the name suggests, is a jumbled up paragraph. Okay, and though technically, as you will know in a moment, it's not really a paragraph, but anyway, it's a combination of four, five or six sentences, okay, all jumbled up, and you have to basically rearrange them to form a coherent paragraph. Coherent means things which can go together. There is a logical relationship between those things. So basically four, five or six sentences, mostly, this obviously can change depending on the whims and fancies of the test makers, but this is the trend and this is what is usual. So you're given a set of four sentences or a set of five sentences or a set of six sentences all jumbled up, and you have to rearrange them to form a coherent paragraph. Now, in case of six, usually what happens is that the first one and the sixth one are fixed. Okay, so they are the way they are, and then you're given the middle ones as A, B, C, D or even 2, 3, 4, 5. And they are jumbled up and you have to rearrange them to form a coherent paragraph. So this is the usual thing in a parajumble. Okay. Now, as I was saying, one of the first things I ask students not to do in a parajumble is the opposite of what they do. Meaning, they do something which I recommend them not to do, at least not consciously. Meaning, they shouldn't really start consciously doing that. And that is that they start looking for a starting sentence or the beginning sentence or the first sentence. And this, from a commonsensical point of view, it obviously makes sense that, you know, of course, if I'm given a set of five, six sentences which are a paragraph, then obviously there has to be a starting sentence. And starting sentences usually are general statements or introductory statements and so on. Okay, now that commonsensically makes sense, but here is the problem. I have two questions for you. Now, this is, let's say, the article or the chapter or whatever from which this parajumble is taken. So now this is a paragraph, okay, of, so these are the paragraphs of that larger thing. My question to you is, those four or five or six sentences that you get in a parajumble, are they necessarily going to be these sentences? Think about it. Can't they be these sentences? And I can do that as a test maker just to make things difficult for you. You know, this will be a relatively easier parajumble and this will be a relatively difficult parajumble. Why? Because I'm starting from, let's say, this particular sentence, let's say it begins with the word however. Now, if you are looking for the starting sentence, and this, let's say, in the parajumble, it is C. Okay, so there is an answer choice called CBDAE. And let's say only one answer choice begins with C. This is the answer choice that you will actually eliminate. And what you have now done is you've eliminated the right answer, because you were looking for a starting sentence. Okay, so there are two, three things you have to remember here. First of all, a para jumble will not be a paragraph, because how many times have you seen a paragraph of four sentences or five sentences, even six? Remember, these are not lines, these are sentences. So four sentences or five sentences would basically be around two lines. Okay, so you have to remember that a para jumble is not a paragraph, first of all, and secondly, it need not be the first few sentences that you get. You can, but it need not be. So my recommendation is, don't consciously look for this. So don't go looking for the first sentence. What does that mean? That means that there are times when the starting sentence will jump off the page for you. Meaning you will look at it and you'll be like, yeah, of course, this has to be the starting sentence. Then it's okay. You didn't do any effort. You didn't make any effort. I don't want you to make any effort, because if you go with that state of mind that I want the first sentence, then in cases like this, you're going to get it wrong.